Yo, back up in this bitch. Go Deep episode 34. Got an interview with my homie Lantern 2814. It's gonna be dope. I mean, wait till you hear what he's talking about. This shit is about to get deep. So let's get into it. But first of all, I hope you like the intro. Secondly, I hope you like the next song that I play. Ha ha ha. Because that's what we got to do now. You know, to go deep, you have to get you a blunt or a brew, a drink and your crew, and enjoy the wonderful sounds of Go Deep. Be right back.
I only talk about Jews, do you fools listen to music or do you just skim through it? See, I'm influenced by the ghetto, you real same dude, you gave nothing, I made something doing what I do through and I give you the news with a twist, it's just his ghetto point of view. The renegade, you been there, I penetrate pop culture, bring them a lot closer to the block where they pop toasters, and they live with they moms, got drop roasters from botched robberies, niggas crotched over, mommy's knocked up cause she wasn't watched over, knocked down by some clown, when child support knock, no he's not around. Now how that sound to you, jotted, bring it through the ghetto without riding round, hiding down, ducking strays from frustrated youth stuck in they ways, just read a magazine, fucked up my day. How you rate music that thugs with nothing relate to it? I help them see they way through it, not you. Can't step in my pants, can't walk in my shirt. Bet everything you worth, you lose your tie and your shirt.
Since I'm in a position to talk to these kids and they listen to politician, but I kick it with them a minute. Cause see, they call me a menace. And shoe fits, I wear it. But if it don't, then y'all will swallow the truth, grin and bear it. Now who's the king of these rude, ludicrous, lucrative lyrics? Inherit the title, put the youth in hysterics, using his music to steer it, sharing his views and his merits, but huge interference, and you should hear it. Maybe it's hatred I spew, maybe it's food for the spirit, maybe it's beautiful music I made for you to just cherish, but I'm debated, disputed, hated, and viewed in America, motherfucking drug addict, like you didn't experiment, nah, that's when you start to stare at who's in the mirror, and self is a kid again, and you get embarrassed, then I got nothing to do but make you look stupid as parents. You fucking do good, bad, you couldn't do good at marriage. And do you have any clue what I had to do to get here? I don't think you do, so stay tuned and keep your ears glued to the stereo, cause here we go. He's jiggin' trick, chicken, chicken, and I'm the sinister mister, kiss my ass, is just a never been afraid to say what's on my mind any given time of day, cause I'm a never been afraid to talk about anything.
Been afraid to say what's on my mind any given time of day, cause I'm a never been afraid to holler about anything. I had to hustle, my back to the wall, ashy knuckles, pockets filled with a lot of lint, innocent, got a vent, lot of innocent lives lost on the project bench. What you hollering? Gotta pay rent, bring dollars in, buy the bodega, iron under my coat, braver, do-rag, wrapping my waves up, pockets full of hope. Do not step in me, I'm awkward, I box left often, my pops left often, my mama wasn't home, could not stress to me, I wasn't grown, especially on nights I brought something home to quiet the stomach rumblings, my demeanor, 30 years my senior, my childhood didn't mean much, only raising green up, raising my fingers to critics, raising my head to the sky, big, I did it, bow tie before I die, no lie, just know I chose my own fate, I drove by the fork in the road and went straight.
See, poet, the summer, regular modern day Shakespeare. Jesus, Christ, the king of these latter saints here to shatter the picture in which of that is they paint me as a monger of hate. Scatterbrained atheist, but that ain't the case. See, it's a matter of taste. We people decide if shade is as bad as they say he is, or is he the latter, a gateway to escape? Media scapegoat, they mad at today. See, it's as easy as cake. Whistling Dixie while I'm waving the pistol at 60 Christians against me. War with the Mormons, bath with the Catholics. See, water, no wonder they try to hold me under longer. I'm a motherfucking spiteful, delightful, eyeful. The new ice, motherfuckers hate to like you. What did I do? Huh? I'm just a kid from the gutter, make butter off these bloodsuckers. Cause I'm a motherfucking renegade. Never been afraid to say what's on my mind. Any given time of day. Cause I'm a renegade. Never been afraid to talk about anything. Renegade.
Never been afraid to say what's on my mind. Any given time of day. Cause I'm a renegade. Never been afraid to holler about anything.
Renegade. Never been afraid to say what's on my mind. Any given time of day. Cause I'm a renegade. Never been afraid to talk about
say what's on my mind any given time of day. Cause I'm a renegade. Never been afraid to holler about anything.
I hope y'all like that song. That was Eminem and Jay-Z, Chopped and Screwed again. That was Renegade. And if YouTube doesn't allow me to play that song and I had to cut it out and put a new song, that alternate song was Raekwon, Ghostface, Pete Rock, Prodigy. Oh my God. Chopped and Screwed. Oh my God. Well, I don't know. It depends. Because most of the times, sometimes YouTube don't let you add another Jay-Z song. It's like Warner Brothers footage. But if it let it go through, then forget it. That was not Ghostface and those guys. That was Jay-Z and Eminem. All right, so what are we talking about today? So the interview we got with my homie Lantern, he's talking about how Stan Lee used to rip people off. We'll get into that. What do we got going on in DC news though? We got DC news. Aquaman is still killing shit. You know, and I made a post the other day about that, how that $1 billion could, that's, I mean, it's nothing but good for the DCEU fan base. It's nothing but good for Warner Brothers. It's nothing but good for even the Zack Snyder fan base. It's all good because that $1 billion allows you to do so much more shit now. Because, you know, they're hesitant on pulling the trigger on stuff because, let's say, Aquaman didn't do good, right? So then they would be like, damn, man, the Snyderverse kind of fucking with me. And they might have pulled the trigger on a lot of our hopes and dreams and pulled the trigger as in not putting that shit out. But now with Aquaman doing good, it just gives a high five to Zack Snyder, of course, again, because he picked these guys. This is just his vision, you know? So I say with this new marketing plan of putting the movie out overseas first and starving the haters in America. With this plan, I think with Zack Snyder, his ability first to cast, one, his ability second to actually make the best movie in the comic book industry, the CBM industry. Zack Snyder does that. I think with that, Warner Brothers is sitting on multiple $3 billion movies because, listen to me, hear me out. You got this marketing strategy that worked with Aquaman, the least popular character in Justice League. So now if you take that same marketing strategy of putting the movie out overseas first and add in, you know, a Superman movie or a, you know, blah, 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 you take your pick. There's so many stories that DC could come out right now with this marketing strategy. And look, with, let's say you now you add Zack Snyder back into the mix, you're sitting on multiple $3 billion movies. That has not happened before. That has not happened before. One, you have $1 billion just waiting if you just say Zack Snyder. If Warner Brothers do anything official and put Zack Snyder's name behind it, that's going to be a $1 billion movie. Now you have this marketing strategy. Warner Brothers, you guys can bring $1 billion to the table. If you put your heads together, y'all had, you know, the Dark Knight series had $2 billion movies in it. But Warner Brothers, you could do this. So you got Zack Snyder plus Warner Brothers. That's $2 billion right there. Now you have the marketing strategy of the biggest characters in the world. The biggest characters that they transcend comic books. These are pop culture characters. Batman and Superman and Wonder Woman. These are pop culture characters. So now you attach Warner Brothers. That's $1 billion. You attach Zack Snyder, that's another $1 billion. Then you attach the characters of the biggest icons in pop culture with this new marketing strategy you have. You're pushing $3 billion easily, over and over and over. I know people be like, that's a lot of fucking money. And it is a lot of fucking money. But the way this fan base is set up right now, that they are just chopping at the bit. They're starving to spend their fucking money. Trust me, they will spend so much on Zack Snyder right now. Warner Brothers, if you're listening. They will spend so much on Zack Snyder. We just put out a survey the other day, and it was saying some options of, you know, how much would you spend if the Zack Snyder cut of Justice League was released in your region. How much would you spend to watch it? One of the things was like, you know, local $20, stateside $50 to $100 maybe. Maybe regional was another, and you know, out of the country was another. But I'm sure everybody will spend up to $100 on Zack Snyder right now. I'm sure. And you don't even have to market it like that, but if you want to make some extra money right now, you don't have to put out a $20 DVD. You could put the Zack Snyder cut for $50 and it will still sell out as it was $20, as if it was $20. You'll make $1 billion right there. Warner Brothers has, and this is like, it's like a, with Marvel. Marvel is like Aaron Boone. And if y'all are baseball fans, you'll understand this. Marvel is like Aaron Boone. Warner Brothers is like Barry Bonds. You can say whatever you want about blah, 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 steroids. We're talking about player. And I'm not saying anything about Aaron Boone. Was maybe on steroids too, because probably the whole league was on steroids. But scratch steroids, we're just talking about players. Listen to this analogy. So Aaron Boone, you remember he hit that home run, and I think the Yankees won the championship. They beat Boston off of this amazing Aaron Boone home run. Great. That's Marvel. That's Black Panther, Infinity War. That was that home run. Now you have Barry Bonds over here, Warner Brothers, DCEU. They struck out their first at bat, and the crowd laughed at them because they knew the power that they had, they shouldn't be striking out. But everybody knows when Barry Bonds locks in later in the game, that little home run that you did, Aaron Boone, that's nothing. That little $1.56 billion y'all did, Barry Bonds and Warner Brothers, they are able to knock the shit out of the whole stadium into the water. They might have struck out. Phase one, they might have struck out because BVS should have made a lot more fucking money. Justice League should have made a lot more fucking money. But, you know, with this, the bloggers, they didn't really understand how they were getting attacked by Disney with the bloggers and bullshit like that. But with this new marketing strategy, they understand. They're locked in. They're Barry Bonds locked in. Do you remember when Barry Bonds was chasing the home run crown? Every time he was at bat, ESPN would stop whatever they were doing and go picture Barry Bonds. Go watch Barry Bonds. That's Warner Brothers right now. They're locked in. They got the best stories. They have the biggest icons. Now they have this marketing strategy and AT&T behind them. They're about to hit these fucking balls in the water like, like Barry Bonds. I'm telling you. This shit is about to go out of the stadium. You haven't seen anything yet. You haven't seen anything yet. The stories that the Justice League has with the icons is ridiculous. It's ridiculous. It's Barry Bonds locked in. It really is. That's just what it is. And so we've seen some success with Infinity War. We've seen some success with Black Panther. They were still stupid ass movies, you know? Now you see some success with the quality movie Aquaman. See, they haven't got the media success in America because America, it just shows a lot about how corrupt your media is. It shows. Disney owns your media. Aquaman was snubbed at the fucking Academy Awards. How? How is this possible? All of those movies that they put in for best visual effects and didn't put Aquaman in, and like eight of them were Disney movies. How is this? When you want to know how this happens, just say it. Disney pays these guys to do that. Just be honest. Just tell the truth. And they pay them enough to shit on their competitors. There's no way Aquaman should not be involved because Aquaman visually looked better than all of those movies. And like, it wasn't even the best. Like, I like Aquaman, but it wasn't Zack Snyder. If you go back and watch this movie, watch like the first time when, you know, Aquaman shows up on the submarine and he's beating those guys' ass. Look closely because this is some amazing work. This is some amazing camera work and directorial work. Look closely at this shit. When he's slamming the people around, the camera is moving sideways also. You know, check this shit out. You probably won't notice unless you're looking for it. But when he lifts these guys up and slams them on the wall, the camera moves sideways like the camera is being slammed up on the wall. That's James Wan right there. It was amazing, but it wasn't Zack Snyder shit. I could still watch Man of Steel right now and be like, oh my God. And I've seen Man of Steel like 15 times. I watched it yesterday and I was like, yo, what the fuck? So to get Zack Snyder back right now at the head of the success, the most success DC has ever had, to crown that shit with the king of DC right now, Marvel just should just hang it up. Marvel should just hang it up. And that no matter what they do, I saw they had a little, you know, they had Hugh Jackman's picture like it was gonna be an Infinity War or some shit. Nobody cares about that shit no more, dog. Not Infinity War. What's the fucking shit? I don't know, one of those Marvel movies, Avengers 4, whatever the fuck. But nobody cares about that shit, right, really. Now all the Marvel fans have turned into little bloggers and they're sitting here fucking trolling the DC fans just to get likes. The other day, I can't remember the dude's name, but he said he had some great news coming out on Saturday. Hold on to your ass. Then on Saturday, his great news was some fucking, you know, an article about the fucking trailer of Shazam. Bitch, stop that. Stop the clickbait shit. Everybody stop that shit. The Snyder Cut movement, we have to stop allowing this shit also by stop falling for it. We're looking for any news right now. But hey guys, what I want us to do now is let's control the news. Next time the dude come out and put some stupid shit out like that, we just say, you know, oh, okay, we don't want to deal with your publication anymore. We're going to take our millions of clicks and we're going to give it to somebody else who doesn't clickbait us. Right? We shouldn't even reply to these dumbass shit no more, because every time we reply and retweet or whatever, that is just doing what they want us to do. Whether we hate it and talk about it and retweet it and share it and like or unlike or dislike, that's just still clicking on their shit. That's what they want us to do. So we got to come together and not give these guys our attention, because our attention comes with a million clicks. Snyder Cut movement, we got to hold our attention to us and give that million clicks to real shit like Go Deep Podcast. Ya bitch. Let's get into this interview with my homeboy, Alex Andres, a.k.a. Lantern 2814. We're about to talk about Stan Lee and his biting ass, how he be stealing people's shit, taking credit for people's shit. I know he's dead right now, rest in peace, but yo, your legacy is your legacy, bro. We continue this shit on Go Deep, episode 34, with me and your mother. Sorry, not your mother. Yeah, bitch. Yeah, I saw that shit. I watched it a little bit. I was at work when I saw you post it, and I watched it a little bit, and I kind of got the gist of what you were talking about. But, you know, I'm going to let you tell it, you know?
Yeah, it wasn't really much of an opinion. I just, like, got clips together of Stan Lee, you know, talking about how Steve Ditko wanted, like, to be co-creator. And, you know, Stan Lee didn't even give him that opportunity till like, 1999, like, 37 years after Spider-Man was created. So, you know, there's a lot of shady stuff when it comes to Stan Lee and comics and stuff. Right. I mean, people are going to find out how I personally feel about Stan Lee eventually. But I kind of want to keep that, you know, hidden. But like, I just want to show people that, you know, he took a lot of credit that wasn't his to take, you know?
Right. Right.
He's like the Steve Jobs of comic books.
That's funny. So, damn, I forgot to introduce you. We're doing a show today. I got my homie Lantern 2814, and we're talking about Stan Lee taking a lot of credit for shit he didn't do. Sorry, but we got to talk about it. All right, so tell me, you said there's a lot of shady shit going on in comics. Tell me some more shady shit, like what?
Well, you know, I started reading comics like probably like 10 years ago, and you only find out about this shit when you look into it, you know, in documentaries and stuff.
Right.
You know, the first case I saw of somebody taking sole credit was Bob Kane for Batman.
Right.
He took sole credit, even though Bill Finger created the design of Batman and the backstory of Batman.
Wow, okay.
And he even came up with Bruce Wayne's name. And he never got credit for the character till Batman versus Superman, that movie.
Wow.
That's when he got credit for creating Batman. Yeah.
So Zack Snyder was the first to get
Zack Snyder was the first director. Yeah.
Oh, wow. That's dope. That's dope. So they got like a little backfighting. Tell me some more about Stan Lee. Some shit that he's done that maybe.
Yeah. So Stan Lee was given sole credit of almost every Marvel character for almost like five decades. He was credited with Hulk, Captain America, Fantastic Four, X-Men, Spider-Man, of course. Spider-Man's the biggest one because Spider-Man's the most popular character ever.
Right.
Like, he's up there. Right. And it's kind of crazy to think one man created all that. And it's just not true. Most of the artists created those characters. He just told them, like, what kind of character he wanted. He just wanted a guy with spider powers. That's all he said.
Wow.
And Steve Ditko created Spider-Man's costume, Spider-Man's name, his backstory.
Wow.
And Stan Lee would just say, I want this issue to be about, you know, Spider-Man fighting Sandman. Go. You know, and they would make the story with the dialogue. And then Stan Lee would take full credit for it.
Wow. That's like Kanye West.
Yeah, this stuff happened for decades.
Wow, that's crazy. So what kind of backing do Stan Lee have to have to get that type of power in the comic book industry? Who gives him that type of power?
Marvel did. He was the lead editor of Marvel Comics when it first started, so he had full power over everything. He was telling everybody what stories to write and stuff like that. And he's the reason Marvel became so successful. So, you know, he's not all bad. He did create like one of the biggest brands in comic books off of marketing and stuff like that. But yeah, I mean, he took a lot of credit that wasn't his, and he was happy to take the credit. There was an interview where he said, he'll take any credit that's not nailed down, you know?
Yeah, I saw that.
He wasn't humble at all about this.
That's crazy. So how much of that you think he, of course, he turned that into money. So that's basically like he's cheating a lot of people out of money.
Yeah, Steve Ditko didn't see a dime from Spider-Man until like the 2000s. Like, he was starving in the 90s. Like, he was living in a one-bedroom apartment and stuff like that.
Oh, that sucks.
And he created one of the most popular characters on the planet. Yeah.
Wow. That's crazy. That is crazy. So what did you get any backlash? I mean, you know, you get any backlash so far from your video, from the Marvel fans?
Oh yeah. I mean, a lot of people that read comics and like know the history already know this. This is common knowledge.
Right.
But a lot of people, it's like the first time they're hearing it because all they've seen is like the movies and all the Stan Lee cameos.
Right.
So they think he like created every character by himself.
Right.
And it's just not true.
Damn, Stan.
But you know, I'm not trying to put anyone down for liking Stan Lee. I'm just saying maybe he like, you know, shouldn't get all this credit. You know, he shouldn't be revered like he is now, right?
Right. That's wild. So now I'm thinking more of like, does that happen do you know if that happened in the DC universe? Does that happen over here? Because, you know, don't these writers just bounce back and forth, you know?
Yeah, a lot of these writers bounce back and forth, but it did happen in DC with Batman. That's like the biggest case. Was Batman. And it happened with Superman for a while, but Superman, like, I think it was Jerry Siegel and Joe Shuster, and they, like, Jerry Siegel took credit for, like, maybe, like, a few decades, but then he came around and he gave Joe Shuster, like, credit, too. So, you know, that one didn't last as long, but usually one guy will take credit because there's just a lot of money at stake. You know, you'll get a lot of money if you say you're the guy who created it.
Right,
you know, a lot of royalties.
Right. That's crazy. Cause like me, I'm just like a regular dude, man. I like comics. I grew up, you know, kind of watching X-Men. I used to watch the X-Men as a kid, the animated series. I used to watch Batman animated series, but I never was really, really into comics like that. I started getting into the comic book movies around like Dark Knight Rises and shit like that. But sometimes when I hear you guys talk, it's like y'all are speaking in a whole nother language because I'm like, how the fuck do these guys know all of this shit? You know, like, what do you do? That you're just supposed to read comics as a kid or what?
Dude, well, I mean, after you read a bunch of comics, like, the comics don't take that long to read, honestly. Like, I could read a trade paperback in like less than 30 minutes, you know?
Right.
So afterwards, you kind of like look into who wrote it, right? Like, and you see what other books they wrote. and then you see who the artists they like the most, because a lot of writers like one artist right. to work with.
Right.
And, you know, you see who that artist also worked with, and you just fall down a rabbit hole and stuff. You see who worked with who.
Right.
And eventually, you know, you get to a point where, you know, you find out Stan Lee didn't create Spider-Man.
That's crazy. So are people shitting on you now because he's dead? You know, are people just like pissed at you for saying this?
I had one guy say it was too soon, and I'm like, how much longer we gotta wait? You know, do we have to wait like 3 years or something? Like, I mean, I didn't put this out the day he died, you know. I waited 2 months, you know, that's pretty good. That's
right, pretty, right. I mean, that's enough time.
I could have put it out the day he died, right?
Right, you could have. I mean, the way these Marvel fans treat us, you know, that would be fair game to some of the shit I see, you know?
Yeah. I mean, I'm sure a lot of people are still sensitive about Stan Lee and stuff, but, you know, the guy never went to a convention with other comic book writers, you know? He was not liked in the comic book industry.
Right.
And not at all. Like, you never saw him on a panel with a bunch of other, you know, guys from the 60s that wrote comics and stuff.
Right, right.
He was always by himself signing books and stuff.
Right, right.
Yo, I'm going to ask you. There's a reason for that. There's a reason. Yeah.
I'm going to ask you a weird-ass question. I know you say there's a reason that he's always by himself, and that reason is maybe because he's stealing people's shit, correct. But let me ask you a weirder question. Do you think this is like these old comic book writers and shit like that are just masking like military intelligence, and they're just writing different missions that has happened, and they're just putting it like in a different, you know, kind of like a nonfiction way so everybody can get it, you know? Because it seems like these writers are some weird-ass people, you know, that know a lot of shit, you know?
Yeah, they're very, Alan Moore is a very weird person. Yeah, a lot of writers are very weird, geeky people.
Right.
But yeah, I mean, there's some credence to that because the CIA had a disinformation program in like the 70s and 60s
right.
where they were spreading false information about stuff they were doing.
Right.
And, you know, that could be a case where, you know, comic book writers were putting like real stories in the books.
Right.
But like masking it with comic book heroes and stuff like
right.
that.
Right. Right.
You know, that could be a possibility.
Right. Because like if
especially because a lot of comic book writers are into, that stuff.
Yeah, yeah, they are. I mean, like you said, Alan Moore, that was a weird ass dude, man. I researched him a little bit and I was like, whoa. But, you know, some of the shit he says kind of coming true, you know? You know?
Yeah. He talks about magic a lot, Alan Moore.
Right.
Yeah. And his, like, definition of magic is, like, anything that can, like, you know, change your perspective or something like that. It doesn't really have to be actual magic. It's just something that makes you see things differently and stuff like that.
Right. Right.
He has like whole lectures talking about this stuff, talking about all of humanity and stuff like that, and how it introduces us to new technologies and stuff like that.
Right.
He's an interesting guy to listen to. He hasn't wrote a comic book for a long time though. I think like Watchmen, V for Vendetta are his biggest books, and that's kind of like when he got out of comic books too.
Right. Wasn't he a little irritated with Zack Snyder? Because I heard he said that he never watched Watchmen or something like that.
He never watched V for Vendetta or League of Extraordinary Gentlemen. He hates when Hollywood takes his books and makes them into movies.
Really?
So it's nothing against Zack Snyder. He just hates Hollywood in general. Because he thinks comic books should stay in their like own medium, you know?
Right.
Because it was made for a specific reason.
Right.
You know, there's a specific reason why the panels are the way they are in Watchmen.
Right.
But, you know, he's never seen the movie, so he doesn't really talk about the movie.
Right, right. And I watched,
which is crazy, because the movie's pretty
good. The movie's dope as fuck. I watched the interview with Zack Snyder, and he was, you know, he was trying to make sure Alan Moore knows that, yo, we're going to stick to it, and we're going to do it justice and everything like that. So then I tried to watch what Alan Moore says about it, and he was just like, ah, I'm not going to watch it. Or so, you know, just like, whatever. You're a weird guy.
Yeah. Yeah. I think Dave Gibbons, the artist for Watchmen, was all behind. It was fully behind the movie. He loved the movie completely. There's even a commentary with Dave Gibbons on the Watchmen Collector's Edition or something.
That's dope.
And he loves it. He loves every goddamn scene.
That's dope. That's dope.
So, you know.
Zack Snyder did a good job on that movie, man. I watched it again like 2 nights ago. I love Watchmen. That's one of my favorite movies.
Yeah, it's just a great film in general. Like, it doesn't even have to be about superheroes. It's really deep and stuff.
Right, exactly.
Yeah.
So what you think about the movement? What's going on in the Snyder Cut movement? What's going on in DCEU right now?
Did you fill out the survey for the movie theater? We got a survey to release the Snyder Cut in the theaters.
Yep, I feel that.
It's probably not going to happen, but, you know, a lot of people are filling it out.
Yep. How do you think they're going to release it? How do you think they're going to release it if they do release it?
Just give me the Blu-ray, you know? Just put out the Blu-ray on store shelves. Let's buy it. Put a digital copy. That's all I want. That's all I want.
Right.
It's really easy for them. It doesn't cost that much.
Right.
I'm surprised they haven't done it already, honestly.
What about the streaming service? You think because, like, Watchmen is just on Netflix, you know? Zack Snyder went streaming that way, you know?
Yeah. They don't have Man of Steel or BBS on the DC Universe app yet.
Damn.
So, you know, until I get those movies, I can't see them putting the Snyder Cut on there.
Damn.
They will get those movies on there eventually, though.
Right. They need to do it like a box
set. It's just a matter of time.
They need a box set release, like all of them at once, you know?
Oh, yeah. But then now that shitty like cover art that they have now with the white covers. God damn. they look horrible.
How's your boy Dave the Film Junkie? I haven't checked him out in a while, man. How's he doing lately?
I think he keeps trucking. He keeps making videos. That's good. I haven't checked out his videos in a while either. You know, he just, I don't know, still talking same shit, same bullshit. Honestly, you know, I don't hate the guy, but he does have very mundane opinions. Like, he doesn't really say anything that's going to surprise you.
Right.
And then, you know, I just get tired of that, you know.
Right.
I want, you know, say something unique. You know, everybody on Collider says the same thing he says.
Exactly. Exactly.
Yeah, but yeah, other than that.
Yep. What you think about them talking about releasing the shit on like a comic book or a animated series, releasing the Snyder Cut animation or something like that? What you think about that?
Yeah, people were saying they want to his 5-part story arc in a comic book form.
Right.
And I'm saying that he already has 3 parts of it done, right, like in film version. You got Man of Steel, BVS, and the Snyder Cut. Right. So 3 parts are already done.
Right.
In film version. So. Yeah, I guess you can give me the last 2 parts in the comic book. That's fine.
Right.
But, you know, I think first things first is to release the Snyder Cut.
Right.
Right. I really don't – comic books are great and all, but, you know, I want to see what he had because he definitely finished filming it. So.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, let's worry about getting that first.
Yeah, that's what I say too because, like, if – on my Twitter page, maybe – like November 18th, 1 day after the movie came out, and I hit up Warner Brothers and I was like, yo, maybe you should release it on animation. But then I thought about it and I was like, nah, because that's not really Zack Snyder. To watch a Zack Snyder movie, you kind of like a part of it because how good it looks, you know? It won't look as good on animation, you know?
Yeah, it sucks you in. The visuals. Right. Definitely put you in that world.
Right.
And, you know, there's not many directors that do that. I mean, even Christopher Nolan, his films don't look as sharp as Zack Snyder's films.
Right.
Like,
right.
And Christopher Nolan's a great director.
Right.
But, you know, there's something unique about, you know, Zack Snyder's work.
Right.
When you compare it to the Russo brothers, it's like night and day.
Yeah, it is.
One's a TV movie. The other one's a fucking actual movie, you know?
Oh my god, you're funny, man. That's why I like listening to you because you like you don't mind if you say fuck, you know, but you always make a joke about something, you know. A lot of these guys, of these guys, they try to be like they're already in the industry, and it takes away from them being regular dudes. But you, on the other hand, or comic book movie marks, or you know, even Film Gob, y'all all sound like regular people, and that's why I like listening to you, you know.
Yeah, I was inspired by the comic movie marks because, you know, they really sound like friends talking. And that's all I wanted to do was just like talk like I'm talking to my friends right. in a garage or something like that, you know?
Right.
I mean, I'm not getting paid by anybody to do this. So, yeah, I'm just going to have fun, right?
You're a funny dude, man. You be tripping me the fuck out, though. Like, seriously. Yo,
yeah.
How far away are you from Miami?
From Miami? About 3.5 hours, almost 4 hours, maybe.
Where? What?
I'm in Tampa, so it's like...
Okay. I go down to Miami a lot, and I'm thinking about making another trip down there soon, man. You should roll out and meet up with us or something.
Yeah, man.
Yeah?
Yeah, man. Yeah, let me know where you're going to be, and we can make the trip down there.
Word.
Yeah, we can go bar hopping.
Hell yeah. You got a girlfriend?
No.
All right, hell yeah.
Working on it.
We can't bring no girlfriends to Miami, dog.
I know.
Hell yeah. So give everybody a shout out, man. We're gonna wrap it up and I'm gonna go get it to edit on the show, man. Give everybody a shout out and let them know, you know, where they can find you, let them know what you got coming up ahead.
Yes.
You know, shit like that.
Yes. Well, you can find me on my YouTube channel, Lantern2814. On Twitter, I'm LanternAlex, @LanternAlex. On VRL, that's just my name, Alex Andres. And, yeah, shouts out to the Comic Movie Marks. We're going to be doing more collabs in the future. Shouts out to you, Go Deep Podcast. I'm sure we're going to be doing more of these anyway.
Hell yeah.
And, yeah, I'm probably going to be putting out some more stuff about Stan Lee in the coming months here. I just got to find more clips and stuff like that.
Oh, I'm going to help you.
But yeah.
Yeah, that's cool.
Yeah, if you find anything, send it my way, right?
Yeah, hell yeah. I got an interview up with Film Gob in about a week. And I'm excited about that shit because I'm a big fan of him, you know? I'm a big fan of his.
Yeah, I fucked up my podcast with him with the audio. So just make sure you get that right. Yeah. Don't fuck that up. He's a cool guy.
That's what's up, man. That's what's up. So I'm going to wrap this up and I'm going to get to editing so we can have I'll put the podcast out later today.
Okay, man.
All right, man. I appreciate it. Have a good one. Thanks for coming on, Lantern. And we'll get back and, you know, of course, we're going to continue this shit. And I'll holler at you later, dog.
Yeah, man.
Peace.
Peace.